Now, after the president announced the closure of schools and students be returned home to their parents, most of these children have been exposed to so many activities as they officially became idle. Most of these children have been involved in commercial activities, mostly employed by their parents, who say it is not a crime. Our reporter is in Entebbe, who's speaking to parents and authorities about this worrying vice, because still it's very unclear when schools will reopen.
When the second wave of COVID-19 broke out with the emergence of new variants, the president immediately announced the closure of schools. This directly sent these children into different economic activities. In Nkumba Bukola, for instance, children joined their parents in quarrying stones, which is deemed normal and not child labor. Our reporter managed to speak to the parents of these children. This then prompted him to investigate why many children under the age of 10, especially in the areas of Katabi Town Council and Entebbe Municipality, are being indulged in child labor. While strolling the streets of Abaita Babiri in Katabi, you come across a boy carrying a basket of boiled maize on his head during curfew time. Our reporter then followed this boy to their home. The following day, he finds him organizing for another day. Parents say the lockdown made them find alternative sources of income to earn a living, but can only achieve this with the help of their children. Surprisingly, these parents are aware that what they are doing is wrong and against the law. However, they remain adamant. But what do the area leaders say about this matter?
As a leader, I'd like to condemn the act of parents whereby they send their kids into vending activities. You find them at night selling bananas, yellow bananas, pineapples, sugar canes, tomatoes, and other things, which is very dangerous, and it puts the lives of our kids at risk, mainly during this pandemic. It's really against the law, sending younger kids to engage into trading activities. That is child labor. But as parents, if you are teaching your kid at home to do things at home, like taking care of the birds, if you are dealing to poultry, taking care of the home garden, that is not child labor. But when you send your kid outside on the street to
Leaders here agree that parents too need to be sensitized.
Child labor, first of all, is not good, but it depends on how you do it. Because again, when you don't make a child active, probably you're not going to get a good citizen. So I gave you an example of the Indian community. They work with their children. Should we call that child labor? No. That is training. So, even as the parents who can work with our children, I welcome that. I only condemn those who say, you go and work so that you bring man and we eat. This child is not worth it to look after the family. That is your full responsibility. So, we must categorize child labor or differentiate it from training a child. So in Katabi, okay, when you move around so many communities around the lake shores, you find so many kids collecting silverfish, fetching water. If they're doing it with a parent, me, I call that training. If they're doing it alone and with commands, that is child labor, and I condemn it as the mayor of Katabi Town Council.
So what should be done to abolish it?
In the evening, as people hurry to go back home, these children remain uncomfortable at the roadside, hoping to get more customers, as in most cases, they still have some goods to sell. Story by Godfrey Sempija for the news in Entebbe.